Let's get more then on today's historic meeting with Derek Chollet. He's a senior advisor for the security and defense policy at the German Marshall Fund of the United States. Welcome to DW.
Great to be
now,
here.
Before today's meeting, President Trump tweeted that relations with Russia have never been worse, and he blamed many years of US foolishness and stupidity. He said, and now the rigged witch hunt. Dissing your own country seems like an odd way to start negotiations with a country that so many in the international community distrust.
This is an extraordinary moment for the United States and for the transatlantic community. If you reflect back on the last 5 days, it's been an unblemished win for Vladimir Putin, from the NATO summit, which was tempestuous and divisive, to Trump's visit to London, where he talked about a hard Brexit, which would only weaken the EU, to just yesterday in an interview calling the European Union a trade foe of the United States, to his tweet this morning and his press conference this afternoon. It's almost been scripted by Vladimir Putin, playing exactly to his core interests of dividing the U.S. from Europe, weakening NATO, and having the U.S. president cast out on his own intelligence community's conclusion about Russia's meddling in the U.S. 2016 election.
It does seem extraordinary. So where does this confluence of interests come from?
One can only guess. I mean, President Trump for years has talked about his desire to be close to Russia. He, of course, had many business dealings with Russia, the kinds of things that Robert Mueller, the investigator in the United States, is looking into. One can only speculate at this point about what Trump's motives are. He clearly has a personal fascination with Putin, and perhaps he's somewhat envious of an authoritarian dictator like Putin. But this is deeply troubling to the United States and its partners around the world.
So you talk about President Trump's actions over the last weeks and months, sort of playing into the Russian scheme of things. Of course, Vladimir Putin is very much looking to reassert Russia's place in the world. And again, today's meeting seems to slot into that strategy nicely.
Absolutely. Even the venue, Helsinki, the Finns are fine hosts, but Helsinki evokes the memories of the Cold War and the superpower summit. And what's surprising to me is how devoid of substance this summit seems to have been. There was almost nothing agreed to. It was very ill-prepared on the front end. And of course, the only news out of it is what President Trump has refused to acknowledge yet again publicly, this time in front of the Russian president.
See, I watched it and I listened to it and I made notes, and I was looking for substance, and there was some talk of a cyber cooperation and a committee to look at our shared interests. But beyond that,
nothing.
But then, would you expect anything substantial from a two-hour meeting where they had sat in private?
Well, typically, when leaders get together, there are what in the government you call deliverables. There are agreements that have been prepared ahead of time that they will announce. There was nothing agreed to here except for an agreement to talk more among bureaucrats. So I'm somewhat surprised by that. Of course, we were also concerned that there could perhaps be agreements that would run counter to U.S. interests or counter to NATO's interests on, for example, lifting sanctions against Russia or choosing to pull U.S. troops or some U.S. troops out of Europe or not do military exercises, the kinds of things that he did after his meeting with Kim Jong-un in North Korea. Thankfully, we didn't see that. And that's, I guess, one glimmer of good news out of this. But I think what was shocking to everyone in Washington, and I think really throughout many parts of Europe today, is the fact that the president still to this moment will not concede that Russia interfered in the 2016 election, that his own intelligence community unanimously agrees.
I'd be interested in your reaction to another tweet, this time from former CIA Director John Brennan. In it, he says, Donald Trump's press conference performance in Helsinki rises to and exceeds the threshold of high crimes and misdemeanors. It was nothing short of treasonous. Not only were Trump's comments imbecilic, he's wholly in the pocket of Putin. What do you make of that?
I used to work with John Brennan in the White House. He's one of the most honorable public servants I know. He's worked for Republicans and Democrats. He's as knowledgeable as anyone of the threats the United States and the West faces today. And for him to say these words, I think we should all take very, very seriously. Just 3 days ago, the United States Justice Department, Donald Trump's own Justice Department, indicted 12 Russians for interfering in the 2016 presidential election to try to undermine American democracy. And for the President of the United States to stand up today and raise questions about that and say that he believed Vladimir Putin more than the U.S. intelligence community, I think is treasonous.
So given what you said about this meeting and President Trump's actions appearing to work within a Russian strategy, Russia to one side, do you think that there is any country that watched this press conference that has, besides Russia, that has any cause to be pleased or indeed to be worried at what came out of it?
Well, I think there's plenty of countries who are going to be quite worried. I think many, many U.S. partners here in Europe that are very worried by what they saw. I can't think that there are many leaders in Eastern Europe, in the Baltics or Poland, certainly the leaders of Ukraine, the leaders here in Germany, France. I don't think anyone's going to be happy with what they heard from Donald Trump. You could see that perhaps some countries that do not wish the United States well are pleased by what they saw. China, for example, right. The more that the United States is mired in this political scandal and wrapped around the axle of Donald Trump, the better for China. So it's hard to see what good has been done in this press conference, in this meeting today.
We're talking to you, very illuminating. Derek Chollet from the German Marshall Fund of the United States. Thank you.
Thanks.